Hi, in this video we will learn how to create our own custom construction plane, and at the end of this video we will learn how we can use this custom grid as a modeling aid. So keep watching. Now, as you know, by default every time you create an object it is created starting from this default construction plane. To change that, go to helpers, click grid, click and drag. Now the size doesn't matter because this is an infinite grid. Now to make this your current construction plane, right click and click activate grid. Now you replaced the default construction plane with this one. Now I can move it up a little bit and maybe rotate it. Every time I create an object now, they are created starting from this construction plane. Now you may notice that the axis of transform, the move, also rotate or scale, they still follow the orientation of the default home grid. To change that, go here to the reference coordinate system and change it to grid. Now as you can see, the z-axis goes in this direction, the x, the y. Also you can use this dialog, the z. So, and when I create a line, press shift to constrain the movement, the creation of this line to make it straight. As you can see, it follows the new grid. I can now move this grid again, change the orientation, and now every new object I create, it follows the new position and orientation of my construction plane. So if I want to go back to the default construction plane, I can click the grid, right click and choose activate home grid. So now we're back to our default construction plane. Another thing, I will delete all. I will create a pyramid. Let's say I want my construction plane to be aligned with this face. What I can do, I can go to helpers again, grid. Now click the auto grid. This will make your mouse work as like a scanner or a detector for faces, for polygons. As you can see now, when I move this mouse over this polygon, so click and drag, and now my grid is created on this face. Now right click, activate grid, and now when I create my geometry, they are created as if this face was the home grid. Like I said in the beginning, we're gonna see how we can use this custom grid as a modeling aid. Here I have this random geometry. Let's say I want to move this face in a way that it follows the orientation of this face. For example, I want this face to be my construction plane, so that the transform axis follows the orientation of this polygon. So to do that, go to grid, auto grid, and move your mouse over this face and click and drag. Now right click, activate grid. Now I will change the size of this to see it better. Now select this object and select this polygon again and move, and from here choose grid. As you can see now, the axis follows this face orientation, so my Z here is perpendicular to this face, so I can move my face in a way that follows the orientation of this face in the Z-axis, or even also in the X-axis. And the Y axis. Now, last, I will delete this grid. Let's say in some cases you have faces that are smooth together. I will select those two faces and I will give them the same smoothing group. As you can see now, when I press F4, they don't show this edge between them like the others. They are smooth together. They share the same smoothing group. So in this case, if I tried to create a grid, and this goes also for any object you're gonna create using the auto grid. If I click here, you can see that I will activate it. You can see that it doesn't sit perfectly on the face. The reason is that the auto grid will average the orientation of this grid based on the average orientation of those two faces. So to fix that, I will delete this grid. I can temporarily add an edit poly on top of this. Click this polygon, go here, and here click clear all in the smoothing group rollout, clear all. So now these two polygons, they don't share the same smoothing group. As you can see now, I can see the edge between them when I press the F4. They are not smooth together. So now I can go back to grid, auto grid, and create my grid, my construction plane. So this is how you do it, and I hope this video was helpful. And if you like it, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel, and see you next time. Thank you.